everyone. Welcome back to Tea Time with Aloha and Coco, guys. I'm Vicky Vigno around here. Don't forget to click the subscribe button down below to be part of the Tea Time family. I look like an alien because I had to put sunblock. Like, my whole face is like three colors. But we're here. We're here at Hollywood Studios, and we're going to be enjoying a couple of things. But one of the things that I want to share with you guys today is that the Woody's Roundup restaurant is officially open. It opened yesterday, March 23rd. We're here because we want to try it. We want to try the food. We want to have a good time. We want to see what it's all about. So let's go into Hollywood Studios and have a great day. Why does this view never get old? I love Hollywood Studios. Funny enough, Hollywood Studios was one of those parks that I hated. And then with Star Wars Land, Toy Story Land, and all of the new things that they've added throughout the years, can't help but fall in love with it. So it slowly creeped up to my number two favorite park in all of the Disney properties, Epcot being number one. So exciting. And we're here. So the first thing we're gonna do is head on over to Toy Story Land. Let's get some grub in our system. So we're here at Toy Story Land, Roundup Rodeo. This is it right here, babe. The Roundup Rodeo. So let's find out. Okay, guys, so we can't eat here because it is reservations only. Let me see if I can get a menu to show you guys what it is on it. Okay, so this is what the Roundup Rodeo looks like. It is a like a barbecue style dining experience. So this is what it looks like for everyone. Again, make sure that you're trying to get those reservations in, because without a reservation, you're not gonna be able to dine. I was under the impression it was a quick service, but it is not. So go ahead and pause this video, take a look at the menu. See what you'd like, what you'd like to have. I've heard great things thus far. Although it opened yesterday, we had some reviews from Disney Food Blog and things like that. So, but just take a look, save it, and we'll just be coming here next time. We'll make reservations. So guys, that sucks. We didn't have reservations. I truly was under the impression it was quick service. It isn't. Just make sure you make those reservations before you head on over to the park. It is a barbecue style dining experience. So you have like the ribs and the barbecue and the potatoes and, you know, all that fun stuff. Again, miss on my end. I really thought it was quick service. Anyways, no need to stress, because some of our favorite food is right here at Galaxy's Edge. So that just means we're gonna be going to Galaxy's Edge, which I'm super happy about. So let's get some Ronto wraps and let's visit Docking Bay 7. Look at that majestic view. God, I love Star Wars. Okay, so we're here at Docking Bay 7. These are the menu options. After that mac and cheese. I love it here, it's so good. Okay, so we're just gonna go right in and place an order. You could do mobile app. In the past, I've just walked in and placed an order. Let me see if that's the case today. Let's see. So I was right, you can walk right in and order, or you can do mobile app, either or. I'm the type of person that likes to order in person. I just don't get used to that mobile app stuff. Don't know why. So anyways, we're here, let's place an order. This is what I usually get. They used to have an amazing Andorian tipiyip, and it was a chicken laying on a bed of mashed potatoes with vegetables and a delicious spicy green sauce. They took that out right after the pandemic. And now what I get is the spicy tipiyip. It's chicken on rice with some corn. The portions have gotten ridiculously small. Like, this used to be bigger. Look at the kids' plate.
This mac and cheese has sauce.
That chicken is like the size of my pinky. This used to be way bigger. The the prices are going up, but everything that they're offering you is going down. That is one thing I have to say about Disney. And then I got some Moof juice, which is like a combination of a whole bunch of different types of juices. Okay guys, so we just finished having our lunch. Now we're gonna head on over to a couple of the shops here at Star Wars Galaxy's Edge. There's a couple of items that I'm after. And I wanna see if they have them in stock or if they are gone. I know a lot of people that have been after them, so some of those are like hot commodities. Let's find out. So we are in the market, one of my favorite places in all of the Galaxy's Edge. There's something I really, really want. And the funny part is that it's so disgusting and nasty. I hated it the last time I had it, but for some reason, I'm craving it. And it's the coffee with the little, like, chocolate puffs, like the chocolate puff cereal. Like, I'm literally craving it. So I think I'm gonna pick it up. Maybe ask for a little bit of extra foam or something. It's right here in this stand. It's the cold brew black cup, right here. So this is it. Last time I tried it, it's coffee, mommy. You're not gonna like the taste. You tried it last time. The last time I had it, I absolutely detested it. It was so disgusting to me, but I kept having it. It was almost like when you can't stop looking at something. So what I did was I just ordered extra foam on it, and I'm gonna mix it really, really well so that the sweetness of the foam can really dig into the bottom. Now you start to see the color change. It's not so dark anymore. So I'm gonna mix it really, really well and test taste it again. But like I said, for some reason I was craving it. I don't know why. Okay, let's see. Oh my God. I mixed the foam, the extra foam in thoroughly. So good. Oh my God. You have to ask for extra foam. If you don't ask for extra foam, it's going to be very difficult to swallow it. It is pure like dark coffee. But with that foam, oh my God, delicious. Okay guys, so I've never taken you inside of all the markets, so I think I'm gonna do that. Just like a quick little glimpse into all of them. So here we have a lot of the Boba Fett items. They have the helmets, they have mugs. The jetpack. They have a lot of the Star Wars attire. They have like the cloaks. Then over on this side, we're going into like little plushies. So cute for Easter baskets. These are like some games. Let's head on over to the next store. Excuse me. Thank you so much. So we're jumping across over here. Here they have a lot of like the creatures. We have this one at home, that one at home, this one at home, this one at home. I like this one. I'm sure it does something. We call this one cow because when you squeeze it, Coco loves this one. That's Coco's. I'm really intrigued by this one. I want to know what it does. It does something because it has buttons. think it opens its mouth. Let's see. Where can we find out what it does? Let me see. Oh, okay. No, nothing is happening. I'll figure it out now. We have more. They have these. They sit on your shoulder. And that's kind of it for the creatures. Oh no, there's one more over here. What is it that this one does?
Which one?
The little frog?
The gourds.
The gourds. Oh, cool. That's so neat. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, that is so neat. Super cool. I may have to take that one home to add to my collection. Thank you so much. Let's head on over to another market spot. And here they have like some attire, some caps, some little fans. Some mugs, Blackspire Outpost. A bunch of little keychains. This is the alphabet translated, like the Star Wars alphabet. And it's so cool because you can see their names, like the cast members' names written with that alphabet on their name tags. That is so cool. Okay, so we're gonna head on over to the area where they have Droid Depot. Let's go. Okay guys, so we are here right next to the Droid Depot. This store has an item supposedly I'm looking for. I'm really, really excited to get my hands on it. So I'll share everything with you guys now. I just need to get what I'm looking for. Is it this? Yes! Yay! This is the Babu Freak. It's an animatronic interactive droid Smith. I love Babu Freak. He is my favorite character from the Star Wars series, aside from Baby Yoda. And he is... oh my god, I love it. Okay, let's see. These are... Okay, look at what it does. So I... How much is it? Well, it doesn't matter. I'm going to get them anyways. I think it's like $50, $60.
That's why I asked.
Okay, let me get my hands on this. Hold on 1 second. They have so many cute items. Look at this BB-8 little crop for kids. I love that for the girls. I want to get something for them because they have May the 4th be with you at school. And I love when they go dressed to the T to school and that they have like all their looks together. Look at that little droid tumbler. Look at that little bowl, salad bowl, the mugs. Little wine bottle toppers. They have DJ Rex as well. Let's see what DJ Rex is all about. It says try me, but nothing's happening. Am I doing something wrong? That's so cool. If you have a bar at your house to put them on top of the bar, so it looks like the one from here, in Galaxy's Edge. Love it. Let me get my Babu Freak. That's so cool. Our series builder, C-series builder, droid builders. And if you guys have never been to the Droid Depot, this is what it looks like over here. You basically select your parts from a conveyor belt over on the other side. And then you come and you build your droid here. We did it with the girls. Actually, we came We built one for myself because I wanted the girls to see what it was like. So I built one for me. They fell in love with the concept and the idea because during the pandemic, we were watching the whole Star Wars series. They fell in love with it. And then I ended up having to pay someone who lived here in Orlando during the pandemic to come. Either Orlando or California, I can't remember. And they ended up coming, building the droid for us and shipping it to us right in time for Coco's birthday during the pandemic. So that was a huge like surprise for them because it was like their dream to get one of these. You see, so you have all the droid parts and you select all the parts you need. So there's different types of droids you can build. You can build like the BB-8 or you can build like the R2-D2 style of droids. And then you just figure out the parts. And then you have a screen there that tells you you need this part and this part. You need the body, you need the legs. You look for them on the conveyor belt until you find the desired parts. They give you a tray, you put all of it on the tray, and then you go to the droid builders over there and they assist you. There's numbers on the floor, so they'll assign a number to you and you just go to that designated number and you wait. Look at that red and clear. That's so cool. Look at the red and baby blue. It's a really cool concept. And then when you purchase it, you can purchase a book bag and you can stick it in your book bag or you can get it in a box. Anyways, so I'm off to purchase my Babu Frick and I'm gonna head on over to another area. Guys, we just got on the Toy Story ride. We call it the Pew Pew ride, although it's called Toy Story Mania. I missed like recording it for you guys as we were walking in because we had like Lightning Lane and we're gonna beat Daddy and Aloha. We're gonna beat them. We have no choice. We have to beat them. They always win. Absolutely not. What's going on?
I hope you win and I hope Aloha wins.
You guys said I hope you both win. You guys said that to each other.
I love it.
Hi, let's get started. Hi, we'll talk to you guys later. I got 162,000. Coco got 56,000.
No, I win.
You won?
Yes.
You won?
Yes, I win.
Oh my gosh. Best in the card, 199,000. That was Daddy. That was Daddy.
I won.
You won, Coco. You did it, baby. So guys, we just got off the Toy Story Mania ride. We're gonna head on over to Alien Saucers right behind me. The girls and my husband are getting a Mickey ice cream. And then I think we're gonna head on over to Epcot. But I got a little golden nugget of information from one of our dearest loves, Miss Quintero. She hopped on and told me, listen, if you're looking for dining reservations and you're kind of waiting and hoping for something to pop up, use mousedining.com. They send you alerts when there's a cancellation of a restaurant for you to snag up that reservation for yourself. So just keep that in mind. Save that tip for your future trips. I already submitted my alert. Hopefully we'll get it in time for dinner. But if we don't, it's okay. We're going to be heading to Epcot now after Alien Saucers, and hopefully our dinner will wrap up basically us going around the countries that we didn't try the last time when we went 2 weeks ago to Epcot. So let's see if that's what we end up doing. But anyways, save that tip. Mousedining.com could save you a lot of time and could get you the reservation that you're looking for your dining experience at the Disney parks.
Green Army Drum Corps, Operation Have a Good Time has begun! Woo!
We're here at the Alien Saucers. We're about to get on. We're next. And then we're going to finalize our time at Hollywood Studios by going to Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway. But there we go. Hold on. We're gonna spin like two monkeys. guys, we're heading over to the front of the park. We're going to ride Mickey's Runaway Railway once before we leave to go to Epcot. And the best part is that because we're going to Epcot and we paid for preferred parking, we get to park in the front once more, because preferred parking is good for the whole day, no matter what park you decide to park up to. Mira quién es. Mira lindo. Qué lindo, chica. Qué lindo. Todo está tan lindo. Guys, remember when I told you yesterday at Hollywood, at Islands of Adventure, that I'd never seen one in Disney? It's here in Disney. It's right by the Disney Vacation Club and like the little market, like when you're going into where the Incredibles are. There's a Fuel portable charger pod thing here. So let's swap them out and get a new one, because I brought mine today. So guys, the only thing I had to do was remove the actual little fuel rod, not the cords or anything. You get the fuel rod and you just place it in here. And as soon as you place it in here, once you've purchased it, you place it in here and a new one comes out that's recharged. So cool. Now we're ready. And the good thing is, now we know you can get them in Disney as well as Universal. It is cheaper here though. One of them was $30, just like one was $30 over at Universal Orlando. The second one, if you buy two here, it's $60. Over there was $75, I think. And if you buy three, it's $90 here in Disney, but over there was $100 and something. So it's much cheaper in Orlando. Good to know, good to know. I have to write it down. And how about a and put it in the pot. Yep.
And how about a pretty, pretty tutu?
A pink tutu. Oh my goodness, so smart. You're very stylish. Look, she's gonna call you. She's a fashion designer, so she can put it together for you. She's a fashion designer, yes. Yes, she loves it. She could work with you and make bows. I know you guys have the boutique, right? Yeah.
I know, I'm a fashion designer.
She loves it. You know that she makes bows? So stylish. Thank you, Daisy.
Bye, Daisy.
Bye, Daisy. There's so many flowers. You're growing them for Daisy? We were just talking to Daisy. Daisy says you got her those shoes. So smart. Everywhere. She says she wants purple ones next. Yes, take a mental note of that. I got you. Oh, and a ring. She wants a pink and purple ring. Ring, yes. I think that one's more important than the shoes. You're in shock, I know. It's a lot of things. It happens. Maybe for her birthday? It's gone. It's all gone.
There's only air. There's nothing but air.
You're making a whole garden. That's so smart. You can plant the flowers, make little bushels and bouquets of roses. Oh, that's so... He's selling the flowers. He's selling the flowers. He's trying to buy her a ring. That's your love. With all your, it makes, gives you butterflies. Oh.
Yes.
It's all right. train? Excuse me, you lady. Do you mind helping these good people into the cartoon while I fix this here locomotive?
Sure, Goofy, I guess I could try.
Thanks! Be back in a jiffy to pick you all up!
Okay guys, so we're gonna be doing something that I've never done before. I'm actually by myself with the girls. I'm so excited. My husband is driving to Epcot and the girls wanted to do the gondola, but we don't want to come back to Hollywood Studios at night when it's late. So my husband is driving to Epcot and we're taking the gondola. So exciting. We're gonna meet him there at the entrance of the gondolas. Let's go.
So we're in the purple gondola.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome aboard the Disney Skyliner.
Okay guys, so we just got off the Skyliner here in Disney's Riviera Resort, and now we're gonna take another gondola ride to Epcot. Let's see. This is to Epcot, correct? To Epcot.
The backside of Epcot.
Yes, thank you. So here we go. It's gonna land in France. We're gonna get off in France. So I don't know which one we'll end up getting, but, oh, you imagine if we get Ratatouille. Look at Ratatouille over there. There's a Remy and a Ratatouille. You see it? He's over there. So we got another gondola and we're headed to Epcot. Oh, how beautiful, girls. Now, once you take the gondola or the Skyliner from Hollywood Studios, you land in the Riviera Resort and then you can go to other resorts or you can go to Epcot. So we are now heading to Epcot and it's going to land in the France Pavilion. So you're not going to go in like the main entrance like where Finding Nemo is or all of that. No, we're landing straight in France. And then from France, you can either go to Nemo or you can visit the other...
Wait,
Mama,
is France Epcot?
France, yep, Epcot. Look, the Princess and the Frog. Aww.
I wish I got that one.
Welcome.
Look, I can see the Eiffel Tower from here, and I can see Colette, Linguini, and Remy. We're almost there. So we just got off the monorail, and right over here, we're going to check into the France Pavilion. So easy, I love it. Great way to connect from one park to the other, kind of rest your feet and just soak in all of the Disney magic. Those things are so cool. And the temperature, the weather, everything has been amazing this spring break. And it's funny because they said it was gonna be super cold and rainy. And thankfully, I mean, the skies couldn't be any clearer. They couldn't be any more turquoise blue, if I can be honest. Okay, so let's go in and then start enjoying all over the world. Oh, so exciting. So we don't usually like to try the same place twice, but this has a violet lemonade and a spicy hot dog, and those are favorites of the girls and myself. So we're going to stop by the Pineapple Promenade first. So we just had our violet lemonades and our spicy hot dog. Didn't document that because we already documented it the last time we came, but now we're going to Mexico. We're gonna go inside the pavilion and we're going to—
Can we do the park?
The park? What park? Oh yeah, we could. Let's do Mexico first.
Okay.
Let's go inside the ride. Because last time we were here, we didn't get to go inside.
While we wait for Dad, because I don't want him to miss out on
anything. No, he's not going to miss out. Whatever he wants to do, we'll do again.
Okay.
So let's head to Mexico to do the Three Caballeros. So we made it inside the Mexican Pavilion. We're going to be riding the Three Caballeros. This is pretty packed.
Yeah.
For doing the Gran Fiesta Tour. The line is moving rather quickly though. This line is usually about 5 to 10 minutes at most. We've never had to wait in this line for a crazy amount of time. So we're gonna ride that while we wait for Babe to get here. If you guys are looking for the absolute best souvenir in all of Epcot, I recommend the ring carvers. They get your name or your loved one's name and they carve it in a ring. I've done it. I've done it for both of my girls. I have their names on rings. It's just an absolute beautiful, beautiful gift. I'll get you a closer look now so you can see how pretty they are. So they have options of making them in solid 14 karat gold. And then they have options of solid brass and silver. Yes, you can get your name or your loved one's name. Super cool. And prices vary depending on the design and of course what you choose to make it with. Guys, so we made it to China and that is the menu of the Lotus House. There's spicy chicken skewer, cheesy crab wonton, pan fried vegetable dumplings, and some boba teas and drinks. We're gonna go with all three options. Our sneaky little babe get us some pineapple with tahini from the refreshment outpost. Is it good? So this is what my hubby picked up at the refreshment outpost. It's called a pineapple skewer with tahini seasoning. Guys, it's perfection. If you guys have not tried mango and tahini, it's delicious. But this with the citrus of the pineapple, divine. So good. You can find it here at the refreshment outpost. Out of all of the menus here, I think the Primavera Kitchen is the most disappointing. There's no pasta at all. It's Italy. You would think that they would create some dishes with pasta, but you know, like some traditional pasta, but no. Chocolate hazelnut pudding, spinach tortellini with sweet butter. I mean, and then like a little Caesar salad. Come on, Epcot. We are expecting some shrimp scampi, some pasta with meatballs, maybe some meatballs or something. Definitely disappointing. Anyways, let's go on to the next location. So we're here in America, the Magnolia Terrace. Let's see what they have. They have the spicy gumbo. Guys, we had this the last time. Oh my God, spectacular. We're gonna get it now. This is so good. Oh my God, this is so good, guys. You have to try this for sure. Here we are. Remy's Ratatouille Adventure. Made it in the nick of time. Oh my goodness, my calves are burning. We've arrived at Gusteau's.
Now can we both go in the front?
Sure.
And you guys go in the back?
Sure. I love this ride. We're getting our 3D glasses. Let's go, we're almost there. I how excited!
Voilà! Venez, venez, venez! Suivez-moi, je vous prie! Bon, les verres, invités pour le dîner!
Yes, we can hear! Pour le repas idéal, en commun? Non!
Simple.
Wow. Mais oui, that's it.
Oh,
spicy food.
We just got off the ride, and there's a super fun fact. Once you get off the ride, there's big tiles to make you feel like you're a mouse, and then eventually you start walking and the tiles become smaller because you're now a human. So look for things like that all over the ride, and you'll notice that there's a lot of small pieces and a lot of larger than life pieces to resemble that of Remy and Linguini. Anyways, oh my gosh, how pretty. This is completely empty. Completely empty because the firework display and the show that goes in the middle of the lagoon is happening as we speak. So look at how pretty. You can hear the fireworks. So desolate. The pastry shop, how pretty. So guys, our time here at Epcot has come to an end. We are heading out. It was a spectacular time. We had so much fun. I am just over the moon with how much fun we had for Coco's birthday. Coco is so incredibly thankful. She loves everything we did. There's so much magic here. It's spectacular. It makes me feel like a kid. So it's a lot of fun. And to see my babies so happy, it's just a plus. So anyways, thank you guys so much for following along on this vlog. I will see you guys very soon on another. Don't forget to click like, comment, share, and subscribe. And we're gonna go catch the fireworks show. Bye.